Hello everyone, I'm Norman Wildberger and I'm here in Brittany with Howard Crowhurst, who is an expert on a remarkable megalithic sequence of sites, which we're going to have a look at today. So Howard's going to give us some analysis and explanation. So thanks very much, Howard, in advance for showing me around.
Well, I'm very pleased to be with you and to share this, you know. Right. It's been my life's work. I've been living here for 35 years and I've spent most of my time studying this place.
Fabulous.
Right.
So this first place that we're at, can you tell us a little bit about that? Where are we? What's special about it?
This site is called the Kerlescan alignments. We're in Carnac, and the Carnac alignments are split into three sequences. One part is called Le Menec, the next part Ker Mario, and the third part Kerlescan, going from west to east. And this is Kerlescan, the Kerlescan alignment, which you can see them going down the slope here. And at the top of the slope, we have this flat plateau, which is encircled by more standing slopes. Okay? And the northern side of this is limited by a mound. And you can see how there's a line which is perpendicular here to these alignments. These alignments are not parallel. They converge to a point, which is on the hilltop over there in someone's garden. And so there are 13 lines which all converge to this point. And at the beginning of these lines, then there's this perpendicular row of stones. And the first interesting point, it looks slightly curved, in fact, but it's because because there's a difference in level between the plateau and the hill. As you can see, it slopes down. A lot of these stones had fallen over and they were re-erected in the 19th century. And when you look at the initial plans, you can see that the ones, most southerly ones, have been re-erected a little this way. And so that gives a sort of curved look to it. But when you take the central part, which where the stones were have always been vertical, so they were not re-erected, so the central part has always been standing. If you take the alignment on that central part, it is perfectly north-south. So that's something very important, is to understand that these monuments are linked to cardinal directions. So we're talking about things here which are 7,000 years old. The beginning...
7,000 years old.
Yeah.
5,000 BC.
Right. So 2,500 years before the official date for the pyramids of Egypt,
yep,
and before the dates for Stonehenge, etc.
Fabulous.
So... The square here at the plateau on the top of these alignments, is a square shape. So its width and its length and its width are the same distance, although it has a slight curve in the corners, but they fit into a square. That is orientated on the cardinal directions, north, south, east, west, because this side is perfectly north-south. So the diagonals exactly 45 degrees.
Mm. And you were saying the middle of the lines of this alignment is also pretty well east-west.
It's east-west, yes, perpendicular to this north-south line. So if you come here at equinox, then you can see the sunrise along these lines at equinox.
Fabulous.
Right.
Is that happening soon?
23rd of September. Yeah.
Do you come down here?
I've been down here a lot. I've filmed it, photographed it. Yeah.
It must be spectacular.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, especially seeing there's no one here.
Yeah. Let's have a little walk, just along here, so we can get a sense of how many stones in this part of the
in this part are about 370 stones, I think, and all together in the Carnac alignments there are 3,000. Bit over 3,000.
3,000. And you were telling me these stones likely come from the mound that may have been over here originally, and they were actually somehow sliced
It wasn't really a mound. It was like a rocky outcrop, and so the rocky outcrop was sliced off, it was flattened. You know, I mean, normally when you flatten an area, you take somewhere made of earth. Well, they took somewhere made of rock, and they flattened that. And you can see in the enclosure, you can see the flattened rock that's been sliced off. You can see the actual bedrock, which is now perfectly flat. So they sliced off the blocks and then erected them here. And I was saying that this face that was sliced off is systematically pointing in the same direction. And the weathered side, which was open to the atmosphere, being weathered for millions of years, that weathered side is always north, and the sliced off side always south.
And the shapes now nowadays are, you know, rather all kinds of shapes, but do you reckon they were all originally rectangular or different shapes?
No. They're exactly as they were. I mean, weathers very little, you know.
Okay.
So the shapes that you see are the shapes they were. If you look at this stone, which is opposite here, you can see how it's been put into the ground with the pointed part in the ground and the biggest part up. That's exactly how it was set up, you know, it's not upside down. This part of the monuments is the most intact because it was the furthest from town, and so a lot of these monuments were destroyed for building purposes, like the pyramids in Cairo. But this part, being furthest from everywhere, is the most intact. So these rows here, a few stones have gone, but all the rest is intact. So it's...
And how heavy are typically these things?
Well, they range from about 5 tons. You can get very small ones and very, very big ones. The biggest one is in Loch Mariaker. It's fallen now and broken into 4 pieces, and it weighs 350 tons.
350 tons?
Yeah. And it's not a local stone. It's on a sort of peninsula at Loch Mariaker near here. And it's made from orthognice, which is kind of layered granite, which is created under the ground because of high pressure temperature. And so that only comes up to the surface at certain spots if there's been some kind of movement, you know, in the crust. And so the nearest quarry is about 12 miles away.
Wow.
And not only the nearest quarry is about 12 miles away, but there is no quarry where you don't have to cross a river. Okay? so there's no... That massive 350-ton stone was taken to that specific spot, and they must have crossed a river to get there.
Incredible.
Yeah.
Incredible.
So forget about ropes and rollers and all that. A Frenchman called Jean-Pierre Moen, who studied how these stones may have been transported for all of his life. He was a university professor, and he spent all his life studying this, and he even made a center near Poitiers, a center of experimental, how people could pull on things and pull stones and things. And once he retired, he wrote in a French science magazine, in fact, there is no real explanation as to how these stones were moved.
Amazing.
Yes.
Absolutely amazing. And we really don't know very much about the people who did this.
No, we know nothing about them. There's no dwellings being found, no sort of massive cemeteries of any kind, no writing, of course, nothing really. Just this. Yeah. But this is enough, you know, if you really want to study it. The first thing to understand is cardinal directions. Once you realize that these things are linked to cardinal directions, then that gives you the basis of understanding all the orientations, because the lines, alignments are long lines, and so they're orientated. But if you don't, the reason no one's discovered or understood this up to now, it is because no one thought about relating them to cardinal directions. Although it's quite clear, that's north-south, you know, it's quite clear. But we just have this idea that can't possibly be orientated.
So we're talking about a reasonably sophisticated astronomy
time. So, yeah. Well, I'd say more than reasonably sophisticated, because we can have north-south relationships between monuments over several kilometers. Mm. Perfect. You know, like hundredth of a degree.
Wow.
Relationships. Uh-huh. Yeah. So it's not fairly sophisticated. It's incredibly sophisticated. It's only since we have GPSs and Google Earth that we are, in fact, capable of determining the exact precision of things. Right.